Hey babes, welcome back to my channel and thanks so much for watching. Today I wanted to round up 10 fall transition outfits for you guys. So a big thing with fall transition time is you never know what weather you're gonna get. That's why it's called a transition period, obviously. It could be super cold in the mornings, like sweltering hot in the afternoons, and then again by the evening you're freezing your butt off. So a lot of these outfits are going to be layers, layers, layers. But I'm gonna share just 10 really cute, easy outfits to replicate. Of course, I will link everything in the description bar below for you guys to shop if you want. But the point to this is truly that you can take many pieces in your closet and replicate it yourself. Don't forget to go below and click the subscribe button if you are new here. I would love to have you join my YouTube family. We're so close to 25K. We have not hit it by the time this video goes up. Then please hit subscribe. I would love, love to reach that by the end of August. And also follow me on Instagram. We're getting so close to 12K, and that's another goal of mine, is to have that by the end of August. So we will see about that, but let's go ahead and get started. I've got some super, super cute looks to share with you guys.
Okay, so this is one of my favorite ways to layer a look in the fall time. I have got a Joy Division band tee over leggings, just like regular black leggings, but I have a jean jacket tied around my waist. You could add a hat with this, whether it's a baseball cap, whether it's like one of these like fedora style here, bunch of different hats you could wear, but I also styled it with sandals. So you've got the aspect of, if it's hot, you have on a t-shirt, leggings, and your sandals. So this is gonna allow you to be a little bit cool. However, if the cool weather hits, you can just take the jacket off, throw it around your shoulders, and you are good to go. You're warmer, you've got a good fall outfit. This Levi jacket is a jean jacket that was my grandfather's. I've worn this like anytime I have a jean jacket on. This is the one you see. They still sell this exact trucker jacket. I don't generally love to tie jackets around my waist because I think it is a little bit bulky, but I mean, to each its own. You could definitely do a chambray, I think that's how you say it, shirt if you want, but just know you're not gonna get that same level of warmth. So this is more like the summer look, and then I'll take the jacket off and obviously show you what I'm talking about, but this is gonna be definitely a very easy fall transition look. So I used to hate when girls did this, but honestly, I do it a lot now because especially if I'm at dinner and like I don't want, like I wanna be a little bit warmer, I just will throw it over my shoulders and not put my arms through. So this is obviously the vibe I'm talking about. You can put your arms through, to each its own, but this is how it would look if you were just gonna throw the little jean jacket over it. Really cute and simple, but good for fall transition period for sure. Okay, so I saw a like caption the other day on Instagram, and the girl was like, it's cool enough for a sweater, but also hot enough for a tank top, so sweater tank it is, or something along those lines, and I thought it was super cute. So a really good fall transition piece that actually has come in style a lot, I wanna say like this year and even the beginning of last year, is the sweater tank. So this one is from Amazon. It did shrink up a little bit in the dryer, which is a little frustrating, but to be expected. So whenever a piece is short like that, even sometimes if it's a little oversized, I just do a front tuck because it honestly makes your look like so much more polished. You do have to like kind of work with it for a second, but very polished to just do a tuck in the front. I did style this with a hat. I took a regular Amazon hat that I have, added a little like leopard hair scarf to it, and it is such a fun little accessory. And then I styled this sweater tank with these Abercrombie like high-waisted straight leg jeans, and I adore these jeans so much. I never thought I would be a straight leg jean kind of girl, but here I am, loving them. Abercrombie jeans fit true to size. I got a 28 in these, so they fit really nice and they are very well made. Like these jeans feel super high-end, like will last for years, and then they do kind of come above my ankles a little bit, and I did get a regular, so I'm 5'9", so that's a pretty good length. And then I just styled this look with some neutral like brown flats. So you could go a few different ways with the shoes, but I really love a good neutral look, especially in the fall. I think that's also a way to keep fall transition looks stylish, is kind of like stick to a similar color palette, and this is my color palette like of life. So neutrals from pretty much head to toe. Okay, so obviously the first few outfits that I'm doing are gonna be a little bit more casual, and I'll move towards a little bit more dressy towards the end. But this one I did pair with my nude Sam Edelman, I think they're said Odila sandals. Now I do have a blister on the bottom of my left toe, or like in the crease of my left toe. So if I am waddling in these heels, it is because my foot is throbbing, but I will do it for YouTube. So I just paired these jeans that I had on a second ago with the heels. I feel like that is such a gorgeous look. I love a good pair of like ripped up jeans with just like nude heels. I did get my true size in these. And then I styled it with a band tee. So this is a tee that has two of my favorite things. It's a band tee for a band that I love, and it's from Amazon. So this queen tee I got in a large, I believe. And honestly, I kind of wish I would have sized up a little bit more because it is a feminine cut. So it's not like, I don't know. I feel like band tees should all be in men's shirts, but that's just my preference. But I do like this. So you could definitely do like a fun little band tee with some straight leg ripped up jeans and heels. This is gonna be a good fall outfit because again, you've got like the neutrals. You could easily throw on a cardigan over this, but you're still gonna be warm because you've got the jeans on. Okay, so one thing I'm finding about this dress is it wrinkles very easy because I steamed this before I hung it up last time. And it is very wrinkly right now. I love this jean dress. It is from H&M. Only downside is that it does wrinkle easily, so I was not prepared for that. But the sleeves are actually long. I roll them up one time just because I do like the way that kind of looks with showing my watch a little bit. But this is a good fall transition piece, you guys know, because anytime you have a dress, you're still letting, like, you know, a little bit of air and breeze get it in this area, but you also look like fall appropriate because you have the boots on. So these are, I believe, like last season Vince Camuto booties. They're similar to the ones that I've seen going around the in sale this year, but I actually am not crazy about those in sale boots. I don't like that they're like pointed toe and then wrinkly up here. I don't know, it's just, it's a very odd style. So I like that these are a little bit more casual all around. I am 5'9", by the way. So you can see where the length hits me. I don't love that it hits like right at my knee, but these boots are just so well made that I will get over it. So a dress and boots for sure is like a really good fall transition style because again, you're just gonna have, you know, breeze that will be able to hit your leg and it will keep you cool. But you know, you've got this like warm kind of style with the boots. Okay, so another outfit. Actually, I'm gonna have a few like all black outfits. So this one is actually shown with Spanx. And before you say anything, I hear you guys. I have a how to style Spanx video coming very soon. But I'm just wearing my Spanx leggings. I wear a medium in these and they fit pretty true to size. So all black outfit underneath, whether you do Spanx leggings, whether you do a black shirt, black sweater, even black jeans, regular black leggings, you can do a bunch of different things. And then just throwing a long cardigan over it. This is a cardigan from Mango. I adore this. I have talked about this piece before. It runs for about $120, but I've never seen it for that full price on the website. I've only ever seen it like on sale for $60. It is worth every penny. It is super long and it's almost like a cardigan. It's very, very soft and it has like a heavy duty feel to it. So very, very good for the cooler weather. And then I just styled it with my Sam Edelman shoes. They do look, it's odd in the color, like coming off the camera, these two tans don't look like they match, but they very much so match. But basically what I'm getting at is you can do an all black outfit and then throw over anything to make the look complete. So like a long cardigan like this, you could do a denim jacket. You could wear even like sandals and a denim jacket. Again, just stick with layers and then neutrals or like colors that are within the same color palette and you're gonna be good to go for fall. Okay, and then like I said, another all black look for you guys. So I've got my Spanx on and then I actually am wearing Sam Edelman booties that I got recently. They are some of the best booties I've probably ever owned. I think his shoes are like without a doubt some of the most comfortable. They fit true to size and I don't know. I just feel like all of the shoes are just so well made that they're gonna last for years and years. So I love them. But this is the look with a jean jacket. So this is a little bit more edgy. Definitely my vibe. But again, you can wear like a white cardigan over this that's knit. You can wear a hat with this look. You can do a bunch of different styles with this and it's still gonna look really good for fall. And then the last all black look for you guys, I just have on a cozy black cardigan, black tank, again, Spanx leggings. You could do black jeans, you could do regular leggings. And I actually styled this with white mules. I love doing like a fun white shoe in fall. This is something I've recently become like kind of obsessed with. I have like white booties. I have these white mules from Amazon that I love. And I don't know, I just think there's something about like the white shoe that looks super cool and edgy during the fall time. So that is how I have this styled. You could honestly do even like gold mules, you could do flats, even just like black if you just want to do an all black look. But again, I cannot reiterate this enough. Stay within the same color palette, like neutrals, and layer, 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 and you are gonna be good. Okay, so I lied, I actually went backwards, and like I'm now sharing a casual look from my last look, but this is not everybody's jam, I get that, I get. How you dress yourself is up to you, but this is totally mine. So I just paired some like high-waisted denim shorts with this like cut-off sweatshirt. I think that this is a really good casual outfit for fall time, because again, you've got the sweatshirt, it's gonna keep you warm, but you have shorts, they're gonna be good for if it's hot outside. And then I just styled it with some of those like Sam Edelman sandals. So it's really, really simple. I think you guys can get the point. I was gonna do 10, but I decided to do 8 because it's just like layer a lot of pieces, make sure that you have like a long sleeve piece with a short look, and you are good to go. All right guys, future me here. I completely forgot to close out the video because the Amazon man showed up and my dog was losing his mind. So thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to go below and click the subscribe button if you're new here. I love you guys so incredibly much. Stay safe, stay sane, and I'll see you in my next video.